The lawyer who represented the man responsible for Norway's worst terror attack says it's important that the gunman behind the Christchurch massacre is tried in open court. A 28-year-old Australian man has been charged with murder over Friday's mosque killings, but police say he will face more charges when he reappears before the courts next month. Now, he's indicated he would like to represent himself at trial. Now, discussions are underway among New Zealand media about how that would be covered. The white supremacist Anders Breivik massacred 77 people in Norway in 2011 and was represented by Geir Lippestad. Mr. Lippestad spoke to our reporter Bridget Burke and told her having his trial in an open court was vital in proving how incredibly flawed Breivik's ideologies had been.
Breivik's court was open, and the news and the television was following it. Not directly. When he was given his statement, there was delay in the television. So if he said something extremely hurting, it could be stopped. But the court was open, and I think that it's important that we have an open court, because when you have a right-wing extremist that believe that there's a war going on, that he believe that Muslim is the reason for that the world is on fire, it's important to meet that argument with knowledge, to argue against it, and that people can listen to the arguments, because there are, of course, no truth in what these right-wing extremists believe. And in a court case, when you have witnesses with lots of knowledge, when you have a judge with lots of knowledge, when you have the police with lots of knowledge, and you have expert witness with lots of knowledge, they're so easy for everyone to see that the beliefs that a right-wing extremist terrorist have is just fantasy. And I think it's better to show that it's fantasy than hide it.
I understand that the gunman here in Christchurch referred to Mr. Breivik, your client, as true inspiration. Do you believe both these men are of the same understanding and belief?
Well, the most obvious similarity is that they are both right-wing extremists, and they believe that there is some kind of war going on, and the hate and their action is against Muslim. Breivik believes that there are lots of different cells all over Europe and the world. And of course, what I read in the papers that the gunman in New Zealand also has been reading the manifesto from Mr. Breivik. I know that the manifesto is out there, and I also know that in the East Europe, for instance, in Russia or in East Europe, there are people that look upon Breivik as some kind of hero. Not many, but some. Among the right-wing extremists, he's in some part of Europe looked upon as a hero.
Do you think it's evil to have the extreme view, or it's evil to execute the actions?
Oh, that's difficult questions. I will say it's not evil to have this kind of use. It's stupid, but not evil. But of course, it's evil to act on them. And I think that the most important thing is to discuss why people have these right wing extremist thoughts, and to use experts in newspapers, in the television, in documentary, in debates, telling what's the truth and what's not the truth. Because, I mean, fake news and alternative news is something that young people have to deal with every day. And these right-wing extremists, they are also looking for the truth, but they are not listening to it because they are not reading the newspapers. But a case like this can also open their minds that maybe we have understand this the wrong way, because there are so many people with a lot of knowledge telling that we have wrong ideas, and I think that's important.
You said before the trial that you feel like you've lost your soul in this case, and that you hope you get it back when it's over,
yeah,
and that it will be in the same condition it was before. Did you get your soul back?
Yeah, I hope so. But when you, over almost 2 years, almost every day, work so close to a man with all this, you know, have done these terrible things and have these terrible ideas, you have to be extremely professional all the time. You can't show everything what you have inside. Of course, you have to be professional, and you have to block your feelings. I have to put my feelings at home. Of course, it's terrible that so many people get killed, and it's. I mean, it's one of the most important issue to solve, that how shall we deal with this extremist? How can we make sure it won't happen again? It will probably happen again, I'm sorry to say, but how can we make the risk as low as possible? And I think that it's important that not young people are recruited into this right-wing extremist milieu, and to prevent that, I think that's important that they get the right information. And of course, I also see that Muslims and Christians and all of people in New Zealand are holding hands. And the rest of the public and the rest of the people in New Zealand are not afraid of each other.